You've seen her comedy concerts in all the big cities, like Zorro, Ohio at the Elks Lodge, at Bingo Halls in Stockholm, Wisconsin, and working the retirement home in Louisiana, Missouri. And now you hear her thoughts on her No Reason podcast. Here's Nola J, the chocolate blonde, on the No Reason podcast.
Can I kick it?
Yes, you can.
Welcome to the No Reason podcast. I am your host, Nola J, aka Chocolate Blonde, aka Jizzle. And I'm with my brand new co-host,
Don Suave, or Swizzle, or Swizzy Suave, whichever way you want to go with it.
Or whatever you want to go by. We're back. This is our second episode together in this season two of the No Reason podcast, episode number 32. So we excited. I hope everyone had a great week. I think I had a pretty good week.
How was your week?
Oh, snap. I was about to ask you about yours. my week was, honestly, I can't remember. I do so much stuff. I know there's something major that went on, but I can't remember. Mm. I know I caught the football game, the Packers, because you know I'm going to get into that in a minute.
Yeah, I know. You got your Packers shirt on.
Yes, I do. I am, I don't know. For no reason. I felt like a Packer backer. Let me see. I honestly cannot think of anything exciting, but it was a good week, I believe. But as we get to talking, things will come to mind.
Yeah.
This weekend, I'll be in Duluth, Minnesota. I have gigs there.
Okay.
I like going there. I like going there during the summer, fall time, like this time. I hate it in the winter. I hate it. There's too many hills in Duluth. And my car is not capable to handle it. And I always slide down hills and stuff. And I always feel like I'm going to die in Duluth.
But you make it.
I always make it. But how was your week? Hopefully you can give me something because I had nothing.
My week has just been busy. Just trying to make a lot of things happen. That's all I can really say.
We got to get more content to this. We have told absolutely nothing to these people.
Well, you know
I can't remember nothing, and you like, I'm just doing what? that is nothing? Is there anything exciting happen?
Well, we're here.
Okay, all right. Well, we'll just move on. Well, I apologize to y'all. Apparently, we in the Witness Protection Program, we can't give out our information on what the hell we do. But, hey, it was a good week, I guess.
But a lot of other shit went on.
Yeah, a lot of other shit went on that we can talk about.
Yeah.
That's what we talk about for no reason. So for no damn reason, you probably never hear true things that we do. Because, I don't know, we saw a murder somewhere. We're really not who we are. All right, let's start with sports. You always don't have to start with sports. All right, my Packers. Did you watch any football this weekend? Or Sunday would be the only day.
Sort of.
And Thursday. You didn't watch?
Sort of. Packers, I kept up to date.
Oh, you did?
I kept up to date. Redskins, I kept up to date for the first half. And then Couple games I took, not the Giants game. It was the Browns. The Browns game with, they look pretty good. The Ravens look pretty good. Lamar Jackson's balling this year, apparently.
You are horrible at this sports thing. This is what I'm going to need you to do. You know you're on probation, right, as a cause. You're on probation. Okay, so next week, can you at least watch one damn game? You can even watch Red Zone. There's a whole bunch of games. But I watch, of course, the Packers.
Mm-hmm.
We won. I love it. We finally got a coach that's eye candy.
I don't know what that means.
Like the broads ain't called you eye candy before. But anywho.
Yeah, me. I don't know what that means.
Well, for me, we finally got a coach that's eye candy, and I really enjoy it.
Who is the coach? Is it the old Dolphins coach?
No, it's Matt LaFleur. I think so, the young cat. I don't know where he came from. I'm not going to even lie to you.
I feel like he was a quarterback coach somewhere.
But he's young, a young coach, very young. He's eye candy compared to Mike McCarthy.
Yeah, every cockeyed ass. That has been like.
Well, we had cockeyed ass Mike McCarthy. He was cockeyed. Mike Holmgren looked like Santa Claus. So listen, I'm just happy to see some eye candy besides Rodgers.
Yeah, Ray Rhodes.
Okay, don't bring up Ray Rhodes. Why do you bring up Ray Rhodes? Everybody know I'm upset at the fact that the only black coach we had, he had a year, they fired him. You know how I feel about Ray Rhodes. Why did you bring up Ray Rhodes? Don't bring up Ray Rhodes. Don't.
But that's he, like, if you know Wisconsin, that's like.
The black coach that we had, they gave him a season and got rid of him. A season.
Yeah.
Mike.
Every other coach.
Mike and Mike. Yep.
It's been like a decade, everybody.
Exactly. Yep. Everyone knows how I feel about the situation. Please don't bring it up anymore. It's a story. I got PTSD when you brought that up.
Yeah, what? You got pissed?
I'm done. So we won. It was a good game. Our offense stepped up. Big time. Our offense stepped up. We had to beat Minnesota. We have to beat everyone in our division. So, but right now, the Bears, us, Minnesota, I think Detroit, I think everyone won in our division. I think. I don't know if the Lions lost or not. Brewers are doing well. We're going to postseason.
They're going to make it?
I don't think you care about this. I really think that I'm the only one sitting here that cares.
They did well last year. And
yeah.
Then their top player, is he out for the season?
Yes, our MVP. He's out. It's devastating.
And the last I checked, they were three out. So.
Oh, so you are paying attention to the Brewers.
Yeah, I pay attention.
Wow.
I duck in and out.
All right, well, how did your Redskins do?
So what else happened in the court?
What happened to the Redskins?
Man, they look bad.
Okay, well, what's going on with
they play the Cowboys. They play the Cowboys. And,
what's going on with the Miami Dolphins? Is that a high school team? What team is out there? Who's playing?
I don't know what's going on down there. But who they play, the Patriots?
It doesn't matter who they play. They just look horrible.
They score maybe 10 points all season.
They just look horrible, period. They look horrible. Yeah. They really do. Okay, so I talk about sports. The Bucks had a town hall, which I liked.
A
town hall where, like, the fans get to ask questions to the owners and Bucks players. They had that. No one else cares about this. I do, because fear the deer. No, it's kind of cool. It's
making
really
a community.
Yeah, it's dope. They had that. I missed it. I missed watching it. But it's
do you know
deal.
What anybody asks? Because what a big thing in the news now is that Giannis is expected to go to Golden State when his contract's up.
He is not going anywhere. Listen.
You don't think so?
Would you haters out there?
I'm just asking.
You guys are haters. Giannis is a buck for life.
He ain't no buck for life.
Yeah, he is.
Nah,
yeah, he is.
No, he ain't.
They treating him well. They didn't brought his brother on the team.
The Lakers did, too.
So,
he's got his other brother.
Listen.
And you know he likes Steph Curry.
He ain't going nowhere. He's not going anywhere. He's not. I wish you haters quit it. You guys hate so much.
We'll see.
Y'all hate so much.
That's what I would ask about in the town hall meeting.
About what?
I said, is he going to sign? Like, what have you heard?
Yeah, he is. Giannis is staying with us. Giannis already said he's going to bring a championship here. He wants to be like. Is it Jordan or somebody? Somebody he admires where they stick with a team.
Probably Kobe.
Well, Kobe, yes. There was somebody else, though. Somebody else, I know he worked with Kevin Garnett a lot. Kevin Garnett worked with him a lot. I think that's what helped speed up his talent, to be honest.
Yeah.
Yeah, working with him. So that's what Giannis says. Giannis is a humble dude. He don't like Hollywood. He even said it. He don't want to be in movies.
Golden State's not Hollywood. That. You know that, right?
That's still California.
Yeah, but Oaktown,
it doesn't matter, man. It's California. That California is all Hollywood. All of it. So, yeah, I don't think that's happening. You haters wish he would leave here. Y'all just really wish. No, and he's not even at his prime. That's the crazy part.
Yeah.
He's not nearly to what he's going to be.
24, 25?
what he's going to be. Woo, I can't wait. I can't remember how old he is. He's young.
Was he 20? Oh, okay.
I wish you get some facts when you come here, because all you do is throw all those random stuff. Like, oh, he's 35, 40.
I know he's young.
All right, well, speaking of sports, or going on to sports, Antonio Brown.
My guy.
Okay. So, remember we talked about the sexual assault with the trainer, and he nutted on her back, yeah, and all that.
All three of them.
All that. So, the NFL said they investigate, and they spend 10 hours talking to her. Well, at the end of the day, he can't be charged. I don't think he can be charged criminally because of statutory. Is it statutory limitation? What is that called?
Yeah, statute
of limitation ended in 2017 or something like that.
Uh-huh.
So he got off on that one, criminally, I think. I think her lawsuit is still probably... let me find an article because I'm just babbling, but I know he got something off of that. But then a second sexual assault came up where he was buying a piece of art or something and he just pulled out his dick. I don't know. Then a fourth thing came out, which has nothing to do with sexual assault. His doctor is pissed off. And there is audio, and I listened to it, and I was laughing my ass off, that Antonio Brown kept farting when he's examining him for his physical. And it's really, I listened to
it. Oh, so that's assault too?
No, he's mad because he didn't pay the bill, and he felt like he was farting on purpose, like he was doing it on purpose.
Who was recording it?
I don't know how it got recorded. At some,
who goes to the doctor and record? See, all this stuff, man. I don't buy it. It's all. I think
someone. It was on Snapchat. I know that, but I don't know how they got the recording. But it is a true recording. I listened to it twice today, and I laughed super hard because I'm immature, so farts make me laugh. Mm. And it was loud and nasty, and the doctor was just like, and he kept saying, oh, I just had a lot of fiber in my whatever. And the doctor was like, you got 3% body fat, that's good. And then he let out a real hard fart.
So you don't call me Antonio Brown for nothing.
So the doc, I think, was speaking out because he didn't pay his bill and he felt disrespected by him farting on him.
So he's suing him? Or he just...
What's wrong with Antonio Brown?
As long as he's in the news, man, he's winning.
You think?
Yeah.
Do you think he really won by what he did? By all the stuff he did to get to... Here, I'm going to read the article on the doctor thing. Antonio Brown's former doctor makes bizarre allegations about receiver's flatulence. Dr. Victor Prisk, who runs an orthopedics and wellness facility in Monroeville, Pennsylvania. I used to live in Pittsburgh. I know where Monroeville is. This is close to my heart. Anyways, that has nothing to do with anything. Blast Brown in an interview with Sports Illustrated over this bizarre behavior during the initial meeting in August 2018. It seemed just childish to me, Pris said of the incident with then Pittsburgh Steelers wide receiver. I'm a doctor and this man is farting in my face. This is what the doctor said. Prisk's allegations are part of a Sports Illustrated report detailing rape and sexual assault allegations made against Brown by former trainer. On Monday, a second woman, an unnamed artist, alleged that Brown exposed himself to her while she was working on a mural for him at a Pittsburgh home in 2017. Brown's lawyer denied the assault allegations. Despite being wary of Brown's flighty reputation, Prisk said he took the initial meeting with the NFL star and took him on as a client. Now the doctor is suing Brown for $11,500 in unpaid fees. Briss said that whenever he would bring up payments for which he claimed they had an oral agreement that he would be paid $500 an hour, Brown would pivot to promising of the two going into business together. In his first meeting with me, he said, "I want to get you on a salary. I want you to be on my team." He tells you he's going to make it totally worth your while, Briss added. He's going to invest in your business, invest in you. You're part of my family. Call God and all that. But he doesn't do that, and he doesn't even pay the bill. So he mad that he ain't pay his bill, and then on top of it, he's mad because he keep farting in his face. And then I heard the audio of it today. I heard it twice, and he farts very hard.
Yeah, how many times?
It's about 3 times, and he laughs after he does it. And you could tell it's a forced fart. Because it's one of them hard ones.
It got too much bass.
It's got, yeah, way too much. And then he starts laughing. You can Google it. You guys out there can Google it. The Antonio Brown farting doctor. You'll find it. It's out there. Mm. So that was his latest thing. And then he had that second thing going on.
It's a wild guy.
This is the thing that's bothering me with the whole situation. With the NFL anyway. You got people who get accused of sexual assault, rape, farting, whatever. And Colin can't play because he kneeled. It makes absolutely no sense to me. Because back in the day, I grew up with civil rights parents. You know, pops. I'm sure your mom was like that. My mom, well, they baby boomers, so they civil rights. So they marched and they fought for things and kneeling and all that type of stuff is the type of stuff they did to protest to go against racism. Colin is going against the brutality of police. Of course, number 45 spent it and made it seem like it was military and not being patriotic, whatever. But you got people getting accused of straight up stuff like sexual assault, rape, and nutting on people's backs. Farting.
No, that's not against the law.
Farting in a doctor's face. But I'm just saying all this, and they still playing, and Colin can't get a job? He can't get nothing?
I heard he turned down some jobs. Two. One.
Well, probably might have been a pay. I don't know.
And two, that's, you know, that's political.
We know what it is.
Yeah.
And we're not going to get deep because this is no reason, you know, we're not going to get deep and political and all that. All I'm saying on the surface, I'm just saying it's just crazy to me how.
It looks crazy.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. It's like, whoa, all this cat was doing was trying to protest some stuff that he felt was, you know, not right. And he chose to kneel. You got Antonio Brown doing everything. This cat is wilding. Like, he's just a pain in the ass. He called one coach a cracker. He got two sexual assault things. He farting in doctors' faces. I don't get it.
Yeah. Well, you know, that's why I like the NBA a lot more than the NFL. Just because it just seems like it's more righteous. Like, it's a players' league and the owners don't. Because Antonio Brown gets away with that because he's Antonio Brown. Colin doesn't because he's Colin.
I guess.
But in the NBA, like, that doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how good you are, how much money you make, how much money you will bring in. If you don't make it, you don't make it. So, but the whole Carmelo conversation is another conversation, though.
Yeah, that's a whole other deal, but that's... I don't want to get into that. We'll get into that one another time because I have my things on that. Still in sports because I'm a Steelers fan as well. Big Ben is out for the rest of the season.
Really?
Oh, hire Colin. Quarterback out. Anywho, and then Michael Jordan. This was kind of cool. Michael Jordan and one of the Bucks and the Bucks owners. And the Celtics and the Lakers owner they launching a tequila.
Okay.
I know you drink tequila. I know you'd be happy to hear this. But he's opening up. Michael Jordan loves tequila. I think everyone knows that. It's a known fact. So he's like launching this business, and he's doing it with the owners. He's doing it with Jenny Buss from the Lakers. He's doing it with Eden's, one of the Bucks owners, the Celtics, and then somebody's wife. So it's a premium tequila, and it's called Sincero. Securo, I'll spell it. C-I-N-C-O-R-O. Sincuro. Sincuro. So whenever you see that, just know that's Michael Jordan doing that. You tequila drinker, you gonna try it?
If it's organic.
Oh, here you go with that shit. Organic, vegan.
Hey. That's the vibe. That's the move.
Okay, here's another crazy thing for no reason. I'm just going to put this random story. I want to read this. KFC. Now, I don't know what the I don't know what the hell is going on with chicken sandwiches. It's getting out of control. KFC is testing some kind of chicken and donut sandwich. So, in case you missed it, America has been kind of obsessed with chicken sandwiches lately. But KFC maybe taking it a bit too far, or maybe not. KFC announced it will be testing a new combination of fried chicken and glazed donuts beginning September 16th. A move that either genius or insane. Okay, I'm going to stop reading this for a second. First of all, why did I feel like I got like clogged arteries just reading that?
Yeah, when I saw the picture of it, I almost called 911. Like it was that, man. That reminds me of the Boondocks.
Oh, they had the best episode.
Uh-huh.
They had the best episode. And the crazy part, well, on another note, the Boondocks will be on HBO. They're coming back on HBO.
Coming back.
On HBO Max. There's a lot of streaming services out there right now. That's a whole nother story. But yeah, so Krispy Kreme does this with a burger. Yeah, they have a Krispy Kreme burger. They have a Krispy Kreme burger with a burger in between two Krispy Kreme donuts. So anyways, KFC announced it will be testing it. Customer has two options, a chicken and a donut basket meal for $5.49. And they make it super cheap. This is why people... I'm going to stop.
Mm-hmm.
Which includes chicken tenders or bone chicken plus a donut, or chicken sandwich $5.99 featuring a fried chicken patty between two donut buns. How many calories is this? The much more exciting option. And if you just want the donut, you can add one to any meal for a dollar. So now KFC is selling donuts.
So, but
what is going on?
Where did that come from, though?
It's random.
With KFC.
For no reason. For no reason.
Exactly.
They about chicken. Like, you don't even deal with donuts. You don't have nothing to do with donuts.
You know, I used to get made fun of because I would go places and order random combinations of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But now they got you going in, you get a bucket of chicken. Hey, can you throw some donuts in there, too?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man.
Let me get a couple crawlers with that bucket. I just want to go.
I'm trying to imagine people sitting eating a bucket of chicken.
Oh, going to urgent care. I'd be urgent care.
That's, oh, man.
I would be disgusted. Okay, so, or maybe they're just trying to capitalize on some of the chicken sandwich craze.
They are, but.
Who isn't? But that's stupid. You don't even specialize in donuts.
Isn't KFC the one that actually came out with the Beyond Chicken for a day?
Plant-based chicken.
Yeah.
How you have plant-based chicken? I'm tired of people.
Out of a bunch of stuff.
Listen, that's another thing. Hold on. All right, I'm done with this. I'm done with that chicken sandwich. So if any people want to go try it, let me know how it is. I'm not effing with it. I'm having a problem. This might be my little rant. I'm having a problem with plant-based.
Because
everyone is using it to lure people in. I just hate the fact that when something like the White Claw. Because now they're running out of White Claw. They should, because it's seltzer water. It's seltzer water.
Right.
I'm so upset about this. I'm like, you guys have been... people are so...
Like LaCroix before that.
People just don't know how to be their own people and be creative. Like, the marketing, all they can see is buzzwords, and people just fall for it. White Claw, that's all you heard, and it was all the suburban chicks that drank it. Now they're running out of White Claw. White Claw is nothing but seltzer water. Seltzer water tastes like shit. People are lying. They're like, oh, that blackberry is really good. Oh, I really like that mango. It tastes like seltzer water.
It doesn't have alcohol in it?
5%. They're running out of it. There's no more. Same thing with this plant-based. And when going vegan, plant-based, Beyonce said plant-based, and damn it, people ran with it. Because Beyonce announced some diet that she did for the, what was it? Whatever documentary she had out. I can't remember what it was. But she had a plant-based diet. And her and Jay-Z been vegans. And then she brought up plant-based. And oh my God, it's the fad. It's all you hear people say. It's plant-based. It's plant. People putting plant-based on shit that is not plant-based. KFC, how in the hell do you have a plant-based chicken? Chicken does not come from plants.
Because some people miss chicken, but don't want to eat a bird.
There is no such thing as a plant-based chicken. It's artificial. How do you make chicken out of a plant?
You can use whatever. You can use mushrooms. You can use peas. You can use... I don't know. It's a ton of different ways to make it.
That's what plant-based is? So you're telling me plant-based is just find a bunch of shit that's not meat and mix it together and make it taste like chicken?
Yeah.
That's plant-based?
If it's made out of plants, it's plant-based. Plant-based is the future. That's where we're headed. And it's just, you know.
So you're going to tell me KFC, the original Kentucky Fried Chicken,
right,
is trying to serve plant-based chicken.
That's what they did, and I saw the line was like lined up outside, so apparently it was a hit. It was down in Atlanta.
That's because KFC and Real Atlanta always run out of chicken. I've been there times where they ran out of chicken at 6 o'clock in the evening. No, in KFC, they're at 6 o'clock in the evening, they ran out of chicken. I'm looking at the sign, KFC, C stand for chicken. How do you run out of chicken at 6 in the evening in Atlanta? Where there's chicken everywhere. You get chicken at the gas station, at the laundromat. You can get a damn oil change. There's chicken. There's chicken everywhere in that damn city. You run out at 6. KFC. So, of course, they came up with some fake-ass chicken. Because they didn't ran out the real shit. That is fake chicken.
Well.
Plant-based chicken don't come from plants. How are you making these? No one can explain this to me. All you just told me, we're going to put a bunch of peas.
You need a recipe?
We're going to put some peas and cauliflower together and some broccoli, and it's going to taste like chicken. Ay, Dios mío.
It's for two people. It's for people that are vegan and just became vegan but miss certain things.
How about?
And for people that are trying to transition over but don't know what to make, don't know what to eat.
How about KFC, Kentucky Fried Chicken? Stick to chicken and let the other people who want to make the so-called plant-based chicken make the plant-based chicken. You specialize in chicken.
You sound upset.
Because they make chicken. They're about chicken. They've been about chicken.
What if they change the name to Beyond Fried Chicken?
It's fake chicken. It's fake chicken.
Well.
It's fake.
I would argue.
And it might be artificial.
I would argue the food.
It might be artificial.
I would argue the real chicken is probably fake, but.
I just think...
Either way, it comes from a fast food restaurant, so...
Either way it is, if your name is chicken, you shouldn't be selling fake-ass chicken. Period. You should get out of business then. If you feel like chicken is not popular anymore, that you gotta sell fake chicken, then you need KFC, all the Popeyes, they need to go. There's other places that will give you plant-based so-called chicken.
Like who?
All the vegan spots.
All of them?
Well, I don't know.
Exactly.
You
ain't none.
Oh, okay. So the chicken place who's known for chicken should sell fake chicken.
They should do whatever pays their bill. I mean.
Oh, so now it's about paying bills.
I mean, they're a business.
So how do we really know it's
plant-based?
They're
not in it to help nobody.
That's what I'm saying.
They're not in it to solve any problems. They're in it to they tested it just to see if. See if it could be a hit.
It's a hit because people fall for anything. You just put a buzzword out there and people running. Oh, they said they got plant-based shrimp. Let me go try it.
At the end of the day, if it tastes good, people will eat it. So if it tastes good and it's vegan or plant-based or whatever, people won't care. They'll just get it.
Hey, you guys, we got plant-based weed.
Well, I mean, that's the point.
Don't it already come from one?
But I see what you're saying about the buzzwords.
It's the buzzword. It's
you got stuff like gluten-free coffee. Like, okay. But they use that to sell it to people.
Oh, but you don't understand the plant-based chicken I just said from KFC.
Well, yeah, because I'm plant-based.
And I know you are.
It's cool to try certain things that I haven't had in years, you know. And if there's a plant-based version of it, I'm going to go check it out.
It should be KFC.
But the market's there. Like, the kids now, the kids are like... There's a lot of vegan kids now that are living in families that aren't vegan. So it's changing. The future is plant-based, just from that standpoint. So these companies, they're just testing the market.
What is plant-based?
Plant-based means you don't eat any animal protein.
So KFC is selling fake chicken.
Well, chickens now that are
fake chickens
that are raised on a farm are fake anyway.
Okay.
So it's
you could get some chickens that could be fed plants.
But they're not the ones.
You could there's ground beef, the cows, the tall grass cows or whatever they are, they fed grass and only grass. You could feed chickens certain stuff, feed them plants, but KFC should not be selling fake chicken. Period. That's redundant. Word. Not redundant. What's the word? It's a contradictory. It just doesn't make any sense. It's KFC.
Yeah.
Another thing I'm pissed off about. It's called green and white candy canes that are actually kale flavored. This damn kale. Here we go. Another thing.
What's your gripe with kale now?
That kale. Candy canes do not need to taste like kale.
Why not?
They need to taste like candy canes.
Why not?
Just go eat some damn kale. Why are you messing with the candy cane? Let me read this.
That doesn't sound good at all.
Candy canes are tired of labels. They no longer want to be stuck in a peppermint flavor box. When did candy canes start talking? Okay. They are spreading their wings, embracing not only slightly unexpected flavors, but also flavors from an entirely different world of category. Kale. Mm. They got a ham and a pizza.
Pizza candy cane?
Yes.
Now, I know that would be a hit.
Why don't you just eat pizza?
Because there's no candy on it.
Ay, Dios. At least, so you want sugar on your pizza?
Personally, no. Never. But I see why be a hit.
At least such is the case over the makers of kinds of candy canes we never asked to find. So anyways, the kale candies promise to offer the bitter grassiness of your favorite vegetable. Why don't you just eat kale?
Because it's not sweet. And you can't walk around.
Add some cran raisins or whatever, cranberries on them.
Snack on it like a piece of candy.
You can snack on kale. They got kale chips. They got all kind of other shit.
But it's kale. It's not a cane.
Why would you want a kale candy cane? I'm over y'all. I'm over you plant-based vegan.
That's like saying, people. Why would you that eats animals want vegetables? Just eat a bunch of.
I eat vegetables though, and right. I love vegetables.
So, why can't someone who's plant-based eat a bunch of other stuff that's not plants?
Leave things as they are. Get your kale chips. You don't need to mess with the candy cane.
I feel like...
Who wants to eat a damn kale candy cane? That sounds disgusting.
I feel like you're going to be really pissed because this is only the beginning. It's going to be a ton...
Listen, first of all...
A ton of stuff.
First of all, I'm not... all about eating animals either. So it's not like I'm this big, I do like a healthy lifestyle and eating right things. I like people to be, I like them to be realistic. Stop with the buzzwords and the coming up with this craziness and trying to blah, blah, blah. Make your own lane then. If that plant-based and all that, make some different shit with y'all shit. Leave KFC chicken alone and leave candy canes alone and go get your own shit and make it plant-based and make it good and do your thing with that. What's wrong with that? That's what I got. But to label everything and just the buzzword to get people doing, like, I made the mistake of last week ordering that Impossible Whopper. Post made it. It was the grossest shit on earth.
Yeah.
It was nasty. I was better off. I haven't had a Whopper since I was like 15 years old. I was better off going to go get a regular Whopper.
Impossible burgers aren't good at all.
That's my first time. I like Beyond Meat. That's good. Impossible Burger is gross. It tastes
it's
nasty.
It's impossible to eat.
Exactly. It was gross. It was nasty. I was just disgusted. And once again, Burger King, stick to the Whopper.
Trying some shit.
Leave this shit alone.
See, that's when it fails.
And you don't think Kale Candy Canes is not going to fail? And you don't think plant-based KFC?
The plant-based KFC
was trying it out.
Because you can make...
No, people were curious to see what it tastes like.
It's just
that's
about
all
how it
that
tastes.
Was.
It's just about how it tastes. If it tastes good, shit. I mean, people eat worse stuff.
Okay, if you say so. Well, I'm going to do some quick ones and then we're going to wrap this one up.
We got to do an episode. I'm going to go into the whole vegan thing.
I wish you would go into something. I wish you bring something.
Because a lot of these fats. So there's basically three reasons to go vegan, and each of those reasons determines how you eat and how you like. So there's you either doing it for health reasons. If you have something that's like you have an issue that you want to get rid of, and plant based is you found is the best way to do it. Or a doctor recommended it. That's one reason. Another reason, because the environment, like just the idea that you have to use so much land, so much resources just to feed a bunch of animals that are using more land and more resources just to feed people in the industry, the food industry. It's just not sustainable. That's why I think plant-based is the future. And all of the people on the board of the World Health Organization are actually vegetarian and vegan. So I just see a lot of these things coming out. But that's the second reason. And the third reason is for the animal cruelty part. So, you know, if you're just doing it for animal cruelty, then you'll be eating anything as long as it's not from an animal. So that's why you see a difference between a healthy vegan and just like a fad vegan and just like a vegan that's just like putting animals ahead of them, and then like their health suffers themselves. So I did it for health and a little bit for the animals. So initially I eat only for is it good. So like the fast food stuff, I wouldn't mess with that.
I don't think you would.
Maybe try it once, but right. I can't. Yeah, that's not for me. So I get that. That's more for people that are just trying to give up meat and just want to eat anything that's familiar to them because you don't know what to make yet. Because you eat every day. You used to have meat every single day. So, okay, I'll try this KFC thing. I'll try this vegan pizza. I'll try this everything that's vegan, fish sticks, right? Like all that stuff. So that's what that's for. But the people who do it for health, I mean, that's not for them, and you know, that's where I could speak from with that.
And I am moving towards to eating healthier, and I do a lot better. And I do get all that, and I'm not knocking vegan or plant-based or vegetarian or whatever, however you want to get healthy in that sense and eat properly. I'm just so sick of the propaganda.
The buzzwords
like, irritate me.
Because a place like KFC, who doesn't serve healthy food at all,
and that's what I'm saying. And Burger King doesn't either. So you come up with one punk ass burger, the Impossible Burger, tastes like shit.
And it comes across
and
like
it
they
comes
care,
out,
right?
And then
like,
people feel like the people who normally, and you said it right, the people who, there's three different type of three different type of ways, and I get that. So the person who thinks, you know, I've been eating bad, but I love Burger King. Oh, they got the Impossible Burger. It's only 30 calories less than the regular Whopper. Mm-hmm. And then on top of it, I think it has a lot of saturated fat. It has something high in it. It's horrible decision, to make. And then the KFC plant-based chicken. Stop playing with people. Stop. Stop, you KFC. My thing is to sleep. I get it. And you're going to have to figure out a way to stay in business. If not, then you go out of business or whatever the case may be. I don't know, sell mashed potatoes and corn or whatever. And that's not vegetarian or vegan, but I'm just saying, just the buzzword, that's what irritates me. It would have been a different story if they didn't advertise it, and then you go into KFC and you're like, and you're with someone, because that's how it normally happens. They're like, I don't eat this. I'll just get like, and they look up and it's like, oh, they got plant-based chicken? Oh, okay. And they discover it like that. Like, there's an alternative. But mm-hmm. to advertise and to go crazy like y'all really healthy, y'all still got all that chicken in there. Same with Burger King. You still got all that shit in there. You right. got one right. ass burger that you offering to act like you healthy.
They're doing it. They do it for the money. You know, they don't. It's not like they care.
They do it for the money, and they're trying to stay alive.
And they're trying to get into that market because they know that market's growing. Like, I saw something about the dairy industry, how people were buying so much less milk now, especially millennials.
Yeah. I used to love milk when I was a kid, yo.
Yeah.
But I mess with almond milk now. I like almond milk. Almond chocolate milk, I don't know what it is. It's really, really good. We'll get back on that subject. We'll do an episode a little bit. Because, you know, I like to make this short and sweet. And I'm going to wrap this up. We'll do something on the vegan plant-based. Because you're familiar with it. You know it. You live it.
Yeah.
And let's talk about it.
I'm actually writing a piece on how to start becoming plant-based.
That's good.
For those in your audience that are interested.
I hate the fact that you use plant-based again, but okay, I get it.
Because it's better.
I know.
Vegan, because the difference between vegan and plant, vegan
is I know like, there's a difference.
Yeah, yes. No leather.
Yes, like, I know there's a big difference. And I know the background of all of it, and I get it, and I know that I act like I'm just so angry because I'm venting. But I'm just venting because just...
I feel you on what you're saying.
What I'm saying is, like, it's legit... a good deal if you go that route, but stop with the bullshit. Like, don't put it on things that you know you haven't been healthy in 100 years. KFC, Burger King, you ain't been healthy in over 100 years, and then you throw this in there and you thinking that. And me being curious, I tried it. Mm-hmm. Get that shit off the menu and keep a Whopper.
Yeah,
it's not even worth it. You like, you just fooling people. Super quick, LeVar Ball called your boy, your favorite player, Lonzo, damaged goods.
Yeah.
After he suggests changing Big Baller Brand. I mean, Lonzo's your boy, right? That's one of your favorite player in the NBA. You're the only person I told you this, the only person I know and met that's a Lonzo Ball fan.
Most underrated player in the NBA.
Okay, if you say so.
But you know, LeVar knows best.
See, you know what?
And so, okay, well, first of all, you know, it's reality TV, so you know how LeVar is when he's got a chance to say something.
Okay, so a little background on this story. They have the Ball family on Facebook. It's a reality show. They're probably in, what, their third season?
Something like that.
It's been going strong. And this happened on their reality show. LeVar was saying that about Lonzo.
Okay. And Lonzo Ball's been hurt the last 2 years, and... they had an issue with a partner that they had, a longtime partner, stealing like $1.5 million or something like that.
Okay.
And that was a guy that LeVar had trusted. And he was the one that's responsible for the shoes being made cheap overseas and they're charging a bunch of money.
And blowing up.
And blowing up every quarter. So fast forward, I guess... this show is kind of like, what is it, like 3-4 months behind or something like that?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I guess at this point, Lonzo was like, you know, let's change the brand. It's got a bad name. Let's move in a different direction. And LeVar's like, we're not changing the name. That's like me changing your name to Alfonso because you damaged goods right now. And then Lonzo was just sitting there like, well, I mean, what's your opinion? He asked the dude next to him. And LeVar said, his opinion don't matter. We ain't changing the name. Now, mind you, Lonzo owns the majority of the company. So,
oh, he does?
Yeah, he owns 51%.
I didn't know that.
He always has. So, at the end of the day, if he wanted to change the name, he could change the name. So, you know. LeVar, I mean, he knows when the camera's on, he's going to say.
So, you feel like he's just doing it for the camera?
He's doing it for the camera.
I just remember that we all was rooting for that family, like a dad who would invest. Yeah. And I still respect him for that, investing in his sons and all that. But we all would sit back watching, like, how's this going to turn out? Like, what? Yeah. But you still a Lonzo fan. You really think you're going to ball out this season?
And Lonzo, he just did a podcast interview, and he talked about they have a whole new facility now in Los Angeles. Like, they're going to rebrand coming this season.
The baller brand?
BBB. Okay. Yeah. So they got new shoes.
Okay. That don't explode?
Longer than a 12-minute warranty.
Oh, my God. So, you really do keep up with them.
That's my guy, man.
I see. You really a fan.
No player has had everything stacked against him like that and is still keeping his head up.
Well, he hasn't done anything, so we're going to have to see what he does in New Orleans, in NOLA, the NOLA.
In the NOLA.
Yeah, with Zion. All right, I think this was pretty good. I think we're going to wrap this up. I always try to make it short and sweet. Anything you want to plug before we head on out of here?
Yeah, make sure you follow me at I Am Don Suave. That's on Instagram and Twitter and Facebook. And, let's keep this popping and
we're gonna keep going. We're gonna keep moving. I'm gonna see if you make it through this trial. I'll be in Duluth, Minnesota. I like going there during this time. Like I said, Duluth is, I like that city during this time, not the winter. Make sure you check me out at NolaJComedy.com. I feel like I'm missing something else, but I can't remember. Because I have the worst memory in the world. But
you have a show coming up in Milwaukee?
October, which I will give you the date so you can update on my website. I have everything updated on my website. But October, I'm pretty booked. And the cool part about it, at least a couple of them are here in Milwaukee. So I get to be home a little bit, and then I go to Vegas. So you guys have a great week. Thank you once again for listening. I think we're going to have an email coming up soon so people can email and reach out and talk to us and ask us questions or something. We'll get that going soon.
Yeah, let's get that. Let's get that.
Yeah, we're in a working process in the second season, but we're going to get there. But thank you guys so much for listening. Once again, I appreciate everyone. My name is Nola J, a.k.a. Chocolate Blonde.
And I'm Swizzy Suave, a.k.a. the Chocolate Don.
You guys have a great week once again. Peace out.
Peace.
Deuces. We out. When I was trying to get this podcast off the ground, I had a lot of questions. Like, how do I record an episode? How to get my show into all the apps people like to listen to? How do I make money from this podcast? The answer to every one of these questions is really simple. Anchor. Anchor is the one-stop shop for recording, hosting your podcast. Best of all, it's 100% free. And it's ridiculously easy to use. Even my chocolate blonde self can use it. And now Anchor can match you with great sponsors who want to advertise on your podcast. That means you can get paid to podcast right away. In fact, that's what I'm doing right now by reading this ad. I love it. It's simple. You know, I'm an airhead, so I just put things together, has all the tools you need. I can distribute this to all kind of platforms. I'm on Spotify, iTunes, Google Play, wherever you listen to your podcast, you can have your podcast there. So if you always wanted to start your podcast and make money doing it, go to anchor.fm/start to join me and the diverse community of podcasters already using Anchor. That's anchor.fm/start. I can't wait to hear your podcast.
Tell a friend to download and subscribe to the No Reason Podcast with Nola J, the Chocolate Blonde. Go to the website, NolaJComedy.com. That's NolaJComedy.com.